All right, so let's go back to 20 questions that we talked about a number of lectures ago. And we're going to consider the following analogy, that in some sense, what is a learner, what is an inductive learner trying to do? It's trying to find the best hypothesis in some class H. And the hypotheses all map inputs to yes or no. Let's say that what we're trying to do in 20 questions is deal with our hypothesis class H, which is maybe a set of possible people. And so these are the possible answers to the 20 questions problem. And X is the set of questions that you can actually ask. So X, they're kind of like training examples. That's how the learner is getting information about what the right answer is. But no question in and of itself might actually be sufficiently revealing of what the hypothesis is. All right, does that analogy make sense to you, Charles?
Makes perfect sense to me.
All right, good. So now let's think about two different cases. One where the teacher is going to try to select which questions to ask. So the teacher is going to say to the student, here's the question you should ask me next to try to figure out which person it is as quickly as possible. And then we'll look at what happens if the learner is the one asking those questions. So in some sense, it doesn't seem like it should make a difference because, you know, in either case, the learner is going to ask the question and the teacher is going to answer truthfully. Just in one case, the learner has to come up with questions, in the other case, the teacher has to come up with questions. So why are these different from each other? What does the teacher have that the learner doesn't have?
Well, the teacher actually knows the answer.
Indeed. All right. So let's just do a quick quiz and say, how many questions are necessary for a smart learner to figure out the right person, assuming that the teacher is the one who gets to feed the learner good questions?
Okay.
Go.